You know, when I grew up in the 60s, in my formative years, that's when they had muscle cars.
Oh, yeah.
And that's how I knew I wanted chrome wheels. It just harkens back to a day. Absolutely. And thank God for Wheelcraft, they were able to get that for me.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Brink of Speed. Today, I have an awesome video with a couple of people. They're followers of Brink of Speed, and he just bought a brand new 2024 C8 Z06. And he went to this company for a great alternative to a set of wheels. So that's what we're going to talk about today. But before we get into that, we are going to go over his whole spec and show you what he did with his beautiful Carbon Flash Z06. So this is Clay.
Hey, Brink of Speed family. This is my grandson, Ioane.
Hey.
Nice to meet you guys in person. Clay is on my Octane Hour all the time, so we've been talking for a long time on there and through emails. But you just bought yourself a brand new 2024 Z06 with beautiful yellow calipers. They got rid of those yellow calipers now. You can't get that color.
And you can't get the carbon flash.
You can't get the carbon flash anymore. Tell us about your spec and why you spec'd it this way.
Well, you already mentioned the model and the year. I spec'd it this way because last year I bought a 23 Stingray off of showroom floor, first time I ever bought a Corvette.
Okay.
It was kind of like a transition drug. Once I got it, I realized, you know, I can build a Corvette.
Yeah.
I started watching your channel and other YouTubers, and I learned, hey, I can order one, and I can design it and personalize it. And so this is what I did. I was able to get, as you can see, the aero on the back.
Yeah.
I got the chrome badge package to match my wheels, and we'll talk about those wheels in a little bit.
Okay.
I got the carbon level two inside.
Yeah, let me go to the inside here.
The yellow stitching with the 3LZ package.
And that's amazing, that black interior with the yellow stitching.
Oh, it really pops.
It really pops big time.
And I got the stealth.
Yes.
Interior just to pick up the black so we don't have that awkward, you know, chrome looking trim around the side. I think it just really makes it a whole lot better that way.
It does, man. I agree 100%. You know me, I'm a stealth guy.
Yes.
So it looks like you also got the same thing that I got on my car.
Yep.
You got the personalized plaque there.
But that one there is personalized from the National Corvette Museum, and you can see me and my wife's name.
That's awesome.
Are both on there. Yeah, it's really cool.
It's really cool.
It's a great process to go up there. And you can see the little gold badge right there in that threshold.
Yep, R8C. There you go.
Now, I know what you don't like. You don't like the chrome exhaust, Mike, because you really like the black one. But because I got the chrome package, I wanted the chrome exhaust.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Hey, that's the thing. That's what's so awesome about having these Corvettes is you build them to your spec. And you wanted chrome accents, and that's exactly what you should have gotten with
it. Yeah.
All right, so now that they've seen this absolutely gorgeous spec that you have here, which, by the way, is a convertible as well.
Right.
Which is amazing. Let's tell them about these wheels that you have on there. They look OEM. What'd you do?
They really are OEM. Wheelcraft does a wheel swap.
And
you can do it at your dealership or other places, but since I went to the National Corvette Museum, Ed, the owner there, reached out to the NCM, established a business with them.
Yes.
And so when you pick up your National Corvette Museum delivery, your RC8 delivery, you just go right to the track. It's about a mile away, and they've got some great people in there. The wheels will already be there waiting on your car. You arrive, they have a great place to wait. In my case, while they put these wheels on, we went down and dropped off our rental car, came back, and then took this car, drove it back to Dallas.
And that is awesome. I love the fact that they do this at the track.
Oh, yeah. Because you don't want to leave. You want your car the way you want your car when you drive it home, right?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And I also love hearing that you drove this all the way home.
I did.
You're not a neighbor Mark.
Oh, no, but with neighbor Mark, and I are kindred spirits because his favorite saying is, go chrome or what?
go home. And you're kindred spirits because of what you put on the front of your car to drive home.
Oh, that Nova Stretch bra?
Yes.
Well, that's convenient. The NCM puts on these parts. Not only did they put on that Nova Stretch bra, what else did they put on? Oh, they put on these rock guards.
Oh, yeah, the rock guards.
Those are ACS rock guards.
Nice.
And so I didn't want any rock chips because I hadn't ceramic coated it at that time or put any PPF on it. So I had the Nova Stretch put on it. I had the rock guards put on.
So you got front rock guards. Look at that.
By the National Corvette Museum. And they did a bang-up job. Only charged me $100 for the labor to install
two
different things. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, that's excellent, man. So is this your second Corvette?
This is my second Corvette.
Okay. So tell people what your Stingray build was.
Like I said, I bought it off the showroom floor. It was a Stingray non-Z51.
Okay.
Hardtop convertible.
All right.
And it had the yellow calipers and also the yellow seat belts. And so I realized I didn't like it at first.
Oh, really? What color was the outside?
Black.
Oh, okay.
But it didn't grow on me.
There you go.
A lot of people have red calipers. My wife says, everybody's got red calipers.
Everybody's got red.
Get the yellow. And I said, you know what? I can now get the upgraded seats.
That's right.
Ones with the carbon fiber right here.
Yes.
I can get the yellow stitching.
Yes.
And I just love it. I grew up
and the yellow seat belts.
And the yellow seat belts.
No, I think you did a fantastic job on this build. And it's really cool, that story that you got the Stingray. Didn't like it at first, but it grew on you, and that's how you built this one. It's hard to tell that this is carbon flash because of the time of day it is, but trust me, this is not black. This is actually carbon flash. So, man, what a fantastic build. Now, do you have any other plans for this car? Or are you finished?
I'm still mulling over a few things.
Okay.
I'm not sure what those next mods are going to be yet. But I will keep you posted on that, Mike.
That sounds great. Well, do you have anything else that you want to tell the audience?
Yeah, there is one thing I'd like to tell the audience. There's going to be some comments that says this is an old man's car. You know what? It is. It is an old man's car.
You don't look old.
I'm 68. Yes, this is my grandson. I'm 68. You know, when I grew up in the 60s, in my formative years, that's when they had muscle cars.
Oh, yeah.
And that's why I knew I wanted chrome wheels. It just harkens back to a day.
Absolutely.
And thank God for Wheelcraft, they were able to get that for me. And yes, this is an old man's car. The average age of a Corvette owner is 61.
There you go.
You know, I'm not going to put a wrap on this.
No.
You're going to put a wrap on your car, perhaps. You're younger than I am, but I mean, more power to you.
He knows me pretty well,
yep.
Apparently. So basically, what he's saying here is you guys need to go to the description below, check out the link to Wheelcraft. Ed's number will be in there as well so that you can give him a call. But like I said in the beginning, this is an awesome alternative to going out and spending $3,000-$4,000 on brand new wheels.
True.
How much did you spend on these wheels?
About $1,800.
$1,800.
Installed.
installed.
Out the door.
So literally you're getting away with a beautiful, beautiful wheel. And like I've said many times, there are plenty of people out there who want the chrome look still. So you're getting a beautiful wheel with your OEM style wheel from Ed at Wheelcraft. And just so people understand this, it's different when they don't go to the museum and get the delivery there. The way that it works without the museum delivery is Ed sends you four wheels
right.
that are chromed, just like the wheels on your car. You get them put onto your car, and then he sends you shipping labels.
To ship them back.
And all you do is put your old wheels in the box, ship them back, and keep these on there, and you're good to go. And it's gonna run you anywhere from about $1,300. I think Errol paid $1,300 totally. He found a smoking deal at a dealership to do it all for him. But anywhere from $1,300 to $1,800 is what it's going to cost you. But still, compared to paying $3,000, $4,000, $5,000 for brand new wheels, that's a great deal. So I think that's it. Give Clay and his grandson a big thumbs up for coming out and showing us the car. I hope each and every one of you have a wonderful rest of your evening, and we'll see you guys out on the road.